So friends, I hope that up till now, the journey that we have been undertaking on road to the analysis of image, or in fact the astrometry via the software of Astrometrica, has been clear to you. So up till now, what we have done is, we have learned adjustment of the settings to perform this astrometry, and first of all choosing this guide of ps1.cfg, the configuration file. Then second part, we have learned the loading of the image with the help of control L, or going from file and taking the images. Then we have learned the astrometric data reduction. In that astrometric data reduction, we have come to see three types of circle stars: the green one, the good stars, the yellow one, the bad reference stars, and the blue one, which have been static in at least two frames of the four which are present in front of us. Next step, we have also gone to see the known object overlay to find any known object which has been earlier known to us, and also to differentiate between known object and an unknown object. So now what we are going to do is, we are going to do a blink utility scan. So this is the option in the blink current image. Or what you can do is, over your keyboard you can use Control plus B. Now once you start blinking, this entire four buttons which are here, where I am making a circle or a rectangular format, I am moving my cursor, you will see them also go colored. This left button, it is used for stop blinking, and the shortcut is Control plus F9. The rightmost button, it is used to start blinking. The shortcut is Control plus F11. Now here, this is a single step forward blinking and single step backward blinking. Now before opening up the blinking of the image and explaining to you the blinking of the image, let me just click over it. A fifth window is generated, and now you start tend to see a few objects moving. Now what actually is blinking? So blinking is, you are just doing a manual animation. Animation in the sense, the first image is put over the second, is put over the third, and is put over the fourth. So all the four images, they are one over the other, and the software, it scans through all the four images immediately, one after the other after the other. So if there is any extra or an abnormal movement, abnormal in the sense which is more than or less than the normal movement of those objects which we are using as reference in our sky. If an object, it tends to move faster in the background of the reference stars or the reference objects, then you will easily identify. And the best thing to identify any moving object is animating the window or animating the photographs or the pictures. Here we have got four images photographed of the same part of the sky in different time intervals. So once we put one over the other, the four images, and we immediately move from one image to second, to third, to fourth. If there is an extra movement, then we will clearly notice that movement in that part of the images. As you can see, it is clearly visible that K15XY4L 20.4 in bracket, the object under discussion, you can see it moving clearly. So this is what known as blinking. So blinking is nothing but you are just animating the image one after the other, or putting one image over the other, over the other, over the other, and you are seeing them simultaneously with a very, very short interval of time. So with the persistence of vision in your mind, you will be able to see any external extra movement. So now what I am doing is, with the help of this zoom in button, I am just going to zoom it for you to show this blinking clearly to you. One, two. I have zoomed it in twice. And let me see, adjust the borders and the boundaries of this particular image, which is present in a sector of 4x4, 4 rows, 4 columns. And if I am able to show you this moving object. Now, this has appeared a bit bigger, but let me zoom it in a bit further so that it becomes more clear to you. Now, I hope this entire movement is now clearly seen by you people. And one more thing that I would like to show you. You see, this particular K15XY4L, it is moving. And here you see the images 1, 2, 3, 4 appearing. So this is image 1, image 2, image 3, image 4. In 4 images, this object has moved this much in comparison to the other objects which are seemingly static. Now you see, there is one more object that is moving. Now here it comes. Here, this, where my cross wire. Now, when this entire cursor, when it moves over this astrometrica pane, it becomes a plus signed symbol. We call it as a crosswire. So here you can see image 1, image 2, image 3 and image 4. In image 4, this particular moving object is gone. Somewhere in the behind the plate or behind these adjustments that are present. So you can see, as a summary, this particular known object K15XY4L, which is just below the square, ideally the object should be present within the square, but sometimes due to some sort of an adjustment, or you can say a manual error or instrumental error, these squares, they are moved up a bit also. So no need to worry, the object is same. So this object K15XY4L is moving in and seen clearly in moving all the frames, maze 1, 2, 3 and 4. This below the object, this one, which is unknown, this unknown object is also seen moving, but at the same time it is seen moving in only 3 of the images. Now you have to consider and take this word in order to analyze an image and analyze a property or cross verify the properties of the object you are claiming to be an asteroid. You require at least 2 readings. So if an object that is present in at least 2 frames of the images, that is either image 1 and 2 or image 1 and 3 or image 1 and 4 or images 2 and 3, images 2 and 4 or images 3 and image 4. So in either of the 4 images that are in front of you, in at least 2 images, the object should be there. Because if you are studying the property of a particular object in one image, you need some counter verification in second image also. The ideal situation is the object is present in all the 4 images, image 1, 2, 3 and 4. But if by chance it is not present in one of the images or 2 of the images, it should be present in at least 2 images. If an object is seen moving and you know that it is moving but it is present only in one image, you do not consider it at all for verification. I will just give you an example. Let me move to the leftmost corner. Here you can see there is an object by the name, let me stop blinking, here it comes. In image 1 it is seen by the name of S3215 bracket 20.7. So the magnitude observed is 20.7 and the designation that has been given is S3215. So here it means that it is an object that is moving and you can see it also moving. Now this is a single step forward where you can move in steps from image 1 to image 2 to image 3 to image 4, and here you can come back single step backwards, image 4 to image 3 to image 2 to image 1. And here in blinking, if you start to do, you get all the 4 images one by one. You can increase the frequency of the blinking also. Now let me increase to 4 and let me show you. Now see how fast the blinking becomes. So in the beginning, I would request you to keep the blinking frequency in 1. Now this particular object is seen only in image number 1. After, let me move it to second step, this goes out of the frame in image 2. In image 3 also it is out of the frame. In image 4 also it is out of the frame. So we do not consider this image or this object for any consideration of a moving object, despite knowing the fact that it is a moving object. Now coming back to the set that we actually were talking about. So let me start blinking it again. So there were 3 candidates in the beginning in our image set, and one we have neglected because that particular image set, it was available, that particular third image was available in only one of the image frames. It was absent in image 2, 3 and 4. Now this particular object K15XY4L is available in all the 4 sets, and this unknown object is available in image 1, 2, 3. So these both are potential candidates for being analyzed on the prospect of being an asteroid or not. So now let us move towards the property analysis of the asteroids and how we use the object identification as a factor. This I will take in the next part. Thank you.